Welcome, folks, to tonight's game. This one promises to be a good one between the Austin Peay Governors and the Chattanooga Mocs. And, of course, we look here at our star watch. What's the starting five look like, you might ask? Well, whether it's a big game or a small game, your starting five has got to be ready to go, Dick.
Well, basketball fans, we have a great matchup for you to keep your eyes on at the small forward position.
Tip of the ball, the game begins. A little two-man action. There's the block. Looking for a good shot. He looks for three. He buries the jumper. He can put points up, and he can move the ball.
He's the type of player who thrives in almost any offensive system. Very versatile and puts pressure on the defense.
Off the mark. The point guard with the ball. Tries for two. He missed. He couldn't get it to fall. The small forward receives the pass. He tries the jumper. They get it to go. Great job of occupying the high post, which ultimately leads to a scoring opportunity.
Well, they're doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Controlling the ball. He shoots from the corner. And score it. Around the perimeter. He shoots from outside. Can't connect. Well, thank you for joining us tonight with Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. I'm Brad Nessler. Davis receives the ball. Nope. Cleans the glass.
Once you get that board, you've got to be looking up court.
For the bucket. Knocks it down. How about that drive to the hoop, Dick?
Well, those aggressive moves to the basket are what this offense is all about.
Pryor picks up the foul. First personal foul. Oh, and you can see the frustration as he picks up the foul.
Oh, that's a bad, bad foul right there, Brad.
This one will come in from the baseline. The Governors move into their zone motion offense.
Boy, I'll tell you what, Brad. The zone motion offense creates a lot of opportunities if you get ball movement and player movement. If you get people to step into the gaps of the zone and reverse the ball, you'll get good shots. You know, seniors are a dying breed in college basketball these days. If you're a coach that's lucky enough to have a couple, it can definitely help you sleep at night knowing there are guys on your team who know what you want and know what it takes to be successful.
Gets the first shot. Charity strike. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
And now, getting set up here in a four around one.
Well, the four around one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket. And another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
They've got a player spotting up on the three. And come up short. Buries lays it home. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He bombs from outside. Knocks it down. Gave it up. In the lane. Bust the J. And work it into a double team on the post. Missed the jumper.
Double team now, bad angle.
He unloads a three. It'd be nice if he could get some assistance out there. That young man is doing it all for his team right now.
Call this a one-man show, Brad. I don't know if it's a good thing or a bad thing.
Savvy receives the pass. Tries one from three-point land. Perfectly executed. Will take the shot. Missed it. Savvy handles the pass. On the dribble, gives it up. Got a nice screen. On the top of the key. Off the mark. Gave it up. He attempts the three. The missed shot.
Just keep shutting the door.
On the left side. Foul charge. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Another great sophomore right here, Dick.
He may be young, but if he's on the floor for this team, you know he's willing and able to contribute any way he can.
He gets it to go.
Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
He may be in some trouble here. Oh, this man's in trouble. On the outside, he attempts the jump shot. Scores it.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
They get that rejected. Nails the J.
Gotta take some pride on the defensive end.
Down inside. Puts up the J. Gets the J to fall. Trying to feed the low block. Goes up for two. Drains it. Takes his jumper. Nope. Out on the wing. There's a double team waiting there. Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Moving it around the perimeter. Jumper. They got it. Working it around the perimeter. Blocks it, and the ball goes out of bounds. on the elbow. They feed down to the low block. Goes up with a shot.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
On the outside, had a screen and gave it up. From left of the circle, plus the jumper.
There's the trap.
Goes up and come up short. There's the tempo for the game thus far.
These teams are selectively pushing the ball and looking for transition opportunities.
Definitely a foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots. I can't emphasize it enough, Brad. It's important to get to the charity stripe.
Got him trapped here, Dick.
Hey, they got him in some trouble, Brad.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
Now the turnaround jumper. Can't connect. On the dribble, gives it up. Shoots from outside. Can't get the shot to drop. Gave it up. He shoots the jumper. Missed the jumper. And the slam. Here's a double team. Puts up the jumper. He takes another bad shot.
Bad shots kill chemistry, Brad.
They work it around the perimeter. From the corner, perfectly executed. Tries for two. That's good. A nice job of getting to the hole right there, Dick.
I tell you, he was fearless right there. Did a great job taking it to the rack. And some great concentration to finish strong. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior.
It's a fast break possibility. He unloads. Jumper won't go. Out on the wing. And the ball's out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. On the left side. They'll work it around the arc. Executes the baby hook. Off the glass and no good. He shoots from the deep corner. The missed shot. Out on the wing. Looking for a good shot. Takes the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. Both teams looking to get things going here. On the dribble, gives it up with a rejection.
These guys are really attacking the ball in the zone.
They don't want to give up anything easy inside. He puts up the J. Nails a sweet jumper. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc. He blocks the shot. Out of bounds, and we're not going anywhere. Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Dick.
Wow, he's really elevated his game. A big-time player, scoring the basketball, doing it all. Just a special player. And you know, he's great to watch.
Here's the inbound play on the baseline. For the bucket. It's good. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Alley-oop. Now they work it around the perimeter. He tries the three ball. Bust the J. Around 8 minutes remaining on the game clock. Getting set up here in a four-round one.
I love the four-round one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Had a momentary look from three-point land.
Excellent jump shot right there. Inside.
He goes up with it. Scores it. For two. Nice shot. 7 minutes left on the game clock.
Look at that spacing.
Goes up for two. Buried it.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Looks at the three. And come up short. He shoots from downtown. Off the mark. Pushes it up. About 6 minutes remaining on the game clock. He pulls up with a jumper. Off the mark. They work the perimeter. He tries the jumper. Missed it. He attempts the jump shot. Nails the jumper. He takes a three. He has taken his team completely out of this game.
These young guys have to remember to let the game come to you. Don't force the action.
On the wing, from left of the circle, he misses the fadeaway. Out on the wing. Looking for a good shot. He launches a three. They get it to go. 5 minutes left in the game clock. Savage receives the ball. He shoots the jumper. Knocked it down. And now there's a whistle and a foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
He'll go to the line. Makes the first. Got him both.
Oh, he drained it. That's on the nylon, NBN.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick. Gave it up. He wants a three. He misses the fadeaway. A whistle and a foul. The coach not happy on the sideline. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Chance for an easy one. It's the first. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones. He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
The Mocs seem like they want to play this game at the next level on defense, Dick.
Hey, look out for the full court pressure, Brad. It'll be interesting to see how the pressure will be handled.
Tries for two. He's typically a good shooter.
Yeah, but not tonight. He's got to accept that.
They work it around the perimeter. Jumper gets the J to fall. Uncharacteristic mistake by the senior. Pushes it up. Shoots from the corner. Scorches the net with a J. And a timeout's called. We got a break in the action. Stay tuned for more NCAA basketball coverage.
It'll be interesting to see who responds how out of the timeout, Brad.
He puts up the J. Busts the jumper.
Pushing that basketball.
Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
He's a human eraser. I love shot blockers. They add such a dimension to your team.
About 3 minutes remaining. Loose ball. Great play. He just threw it out of bounds. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
I tell you what, they get an A for effort in my book so far, Brad. Sometimes that's the hardest thing to get from your team as a coach. When you have everyone on your team working together and playing hard, great things work out.
They're set to inbounds from the baseline. The Governors go into their zone motion now. Pass down low. There's a drop step. And, oh, good defense.
I thought defense reacted and beat him to the spot. Very poor job with the drop step. Very slow.
They got it. Looking to move it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Perfectly executed. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense. Terrific block shot, though. He's a dominator blocking shots on the interior.
Well, whose team tempo went out? That's the question right here, Dick.
You know, Brad, tempo is always important. Every team has their philosophy, and it's up to the players to follow the game plan.
And it's knocked away. Great block.
Wow, what hops, baby. What hops.
Davis handles the pass. Throws it up for two. Out of bounds and a change in possession. Getting set up here in a four round one.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the tray. 1 minute left to go. Off the mark. And the ball's out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
Top of the circle. Can't connect. Had his shot rejected. Scores it. On the outside. Takes his jumper, the missed shot. Lobs it. Goes up for two. He gets the bucket. At the half. The Governors are behind by seven. And here's our game summary.
We've seen a lot of action and some impressive play here today. A look at these numbers can give you an idea of who's been doing what.
Mr. Vitale. That's one of the best parts of college basketball, the student section. They're fired up and they're ready to try to help their team.
The student body looks like they're having some fun out there.
Sinks the shot. On the left side.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Bust the J. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Forcing turnovers was one of the points of emphasis that Dick brought up earlier. They've been doing a pretty good job of this, and the coaching staff would like for it to continue. If they can keep it up, they can give themselves a great chance of winning this game. They're definitely playing with a bit of confidence. Brad?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Moving it around the perimeter. decision. He has no business taking that shot.
Hey, a few more of those, he may wind up on a bench.
Here comes the ball screen. Tries for two. Sinks it. Working it around the perimeter. For the bucket. Got it. Good cut, great pass right there.
That's a bang-bang play, Brad. That's a great cut and an even better pass.
That's why I love this game, Dick, for that reason alone.
Hey, this place is remarkable. The noise is deafening.
On the outside. Nails the jumper. Dick, at defense looks tired.
Hey, that's no excuse. They've got to dig down deep and get the job done.
They're working around the perimeter. Takes the jumper. Knocks it down. Gave it up. He goes for three. Nails the J. It around the arc. Too much. That's a foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Steps to the line for an easy run. He missed it. Cashed it in. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Now, getting set up here in a four-round-one.
Well, the four-round-one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You know, by the time you're a junior, you know what your coach expects from you. It's a matter of bringing it every day.
He hits his first. Dick, they're really getting it done from the line tonight, aren't they?
And a surprisingly collective effort, Brad.
They are nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Into their zone motion now. The man asking for a screen here.
Hey, whether it ends up in a roll or fade, its well-executed two-man game is always a treat to watch.
Dumps it in. For two, he drains the bucket. On the dribble, gives it up. He puts up the three ball and come up short. He fouled him. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Number five to the line for two. First shot is good. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
He makes both of them. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Looking for a good shot. For two. Makes the shot. Now that's how you take the ball to the basket.
Great job of using the bounce to get to the rim. Not too many defenses that can stop that move. There it is, Jam City.
Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Goes up for two. Off the mark with that shot. On the left side. Takes the medium range jumper. Jumper won't go. Gave it up. Dick, when I see those types of things, I just get chills.
Oh.
He makes the block. Knocked it down. Out on the wing. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper. He misses the jumper. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Makes it. Robertson receives the pass. Time to pick up the defense here now. Robertson handles the pass. Gets the J to fall. The Mocs did a great job of going through the high post on that play.
Well, they're doing a great job running their offense, working it through the high post. That's what they need to do.
Tries for two. Goes in.
Hey, no weak side help from the D, Brad.
Looks like they're just standing around out there. With a deep shot from outside. Missed it. On the right side. Arm and foul. They get it inside and a chance for a three-point play as they score. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket. Hey, Brad, you want to get to the line early and often. You end up getting your opponents into foul trouble, and it's also an opportunity to get some points.
Traps in place, Dick. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on.
And the block.
He stepped right into the mouth of that zone but couldn't get the shot off.
Well, the zone did a good job collapsing there. Alley-oop for the bucket. He gets the board. The small forward takes the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. Throws it up for two. On the dribble, gives it up. He pulls up with a jumper. Scores it. And the fans here are loving the action.
Listen to that roar. It's unbelievable.
Goes up for two. It sticks. Lobs it. Tries for two. Snatches it away.
Fill the lanes. That's the only way they'll be able to get some fast break opportunities.
Goes up with a shot. Nails a sweet jumper. And a momentary look from three-point land. Bust the J.
Up it inside.
Unloads a three. They got it. Jones receives the ball. Let's watch the move as he works his man and out a fadeaway jumper. He seems absolutely adverse to taking any good shots right now.
And with that, his teammates may be getting a little bit frustrated.
Gave it up. There's a high screen.
Good job of stepping out on the screener.
Tickles a twine. Number zero receives the ball.
over that spacing.
Robinson manages to keep it in.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. The defense is just getting caught out of position on those backdoor cuts, Dick.
That's a bang-bang play, Brad. That's a great cut and an even better pass.
Gets the rejection. Now in transition. He draws a foul. Oh, looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Steps to the line for the freebie. He misses the first. Problems so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
Dick, you got to be prepared when you go up against this team. They love to pressure in a full court.
Hey, you've got that right, Mr. Nestler. They like to get in your face and force you to commit turnovers.
Kicks it out. Ten to shoot now. Down in the low block, trying to work the lane. He hits it. Teams will play all sorts of tempos and styles these days, Dick. What are some of the characteristics of up-tempo teams?
Up-tempo teams really like to get possession of that ball off the glass and fill the lanes quickly. They want to be able to create numbers to get a 3-on-2, 4-on-3, 2-on-1 advantage.
There they come with a double team to stop it. For the bucket. Great shot. They work the perimeter. He shoots from a deep corner.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
Looking for a good shot. From the corner. Nope. He cleans the glass. On the right side. They work it around the perimeter. From downtown, perfectly executed. Out on the wing. With a jumper, off the mark. The small forward gets the pass. Takes the outside jumper. Jumper won't go. Do they need a timeout here?
Yeah, their poise is beginning to fade.
Let's see if they can get a good shot this trip. Here's the three ball. Knocked it down. Going to move it around the perimeter. And the ball's out of bounds. We'll go back the other way. It's a team effort across the board so far today, Dick.
You can't have any weak links out there at this level. The coaches and players are just too good, and they'll be exposed. So far, it's been a demonstration of teamwork here today.
The student body looks to be full with rage and willing to cheer on the old home team.
Oh, yes, the student body, always full of comedy and excitement.
8 minutes left in the game clock. Off the glass and no good. The Governors are going to have to really be aggressive moving forward, won't they, Dick?
Man, it's basically do or die. They play up tempo, so they could get back into this game. They need stops and quick scores, though.
He hammers it home.
You can almost see that coming. They were a little bit lazy on the defensive end. Just for excitement with that jam.
On the dribble, gives it up. He tries the jumper.
Excellent jump shot right there.
Gave it up. They run it up into transition. For the bucket. Off the glass and no good. On the dribble, gives it up. Unloads. Nails the J. About 7 minutes remaining on the game clock. He attempts the jump shot. Off the mark. On the outside. He throws it up from downtown. They get it to go. Savage receives the pass. For two. Oh, yes.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Robertson is down emotionally right now, Dick.
He's got to step out of it. His team needs him.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Gets his first. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
It's good. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
The Governors are going into their zone motion offense now. Moving it around the perimeter. Hard foul. I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nesler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Savage is usually automatic when he steps to the line.
I'll tell you one thing, Brad. He values these looks. A good opportunity to put points on the board.
Gets his second. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I love the four around one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Inside. Goes up for two. He drains the shot. He shoots the jumper. Can't connect. 5 minutes left in the game clock. Pushes it up. Scorches the net with a J. He attempts the trifecta. The Governors have a hot hand right now that's scoring for them at the moment.
They need to keep feeding the ball. It's simple.
Missed it. The shooting guard with the ball. Tries for two. Good. Four minutes left on the game clock. working it around the perimeter. And now the fadeaway jumper. He misses the J. The Mocs are definitely known for their frantic and up-tempo style of play, Dick.
Up-tempo teams typically have some great athletes, people that can really get out and transition, who really can run exceptionally well, and also can jump exceptionally well.
That's a foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
Dick, we all know how important it is to get to the free throw line.
Well, there's no doubt about it. I think it's such an unbelievable plus. It means you're playing aggressive basketball, you're playing attacking basketball, and you're creating all kinds of foul problems for the opponent.
He doesn't miss that opportunity either. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
The shooting guard receives the ball. Bucket off the glass and no good. On the left side, gave it up. Count that as a personal foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
The Mocs are a pretty good free throw shooting team, Dick.
Well, you know, when a team shoots a high percentage from the foul line, it means that they realize the importance of free throws.
It's two at the charity stripe. That trap could spell some trouble. Fans are pleased now, given the fact that this game is really out of reach.
It's almost an expectation, Brad. You're supposed to win your home games, but winning by this amount, my goodness.
Long ball has really been falling for him, Dick.
They're playing in a way which is getting them some nice looks from long range. Not only are they planting guys, the guys are getting their feet set and are knocking down the shot.
They've got him trapped. And now getting set up here in a four round one.
I tell you, the four round one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. It's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot. A little shake of Baker to use that high post screen.
On the outside.
I think right now, gotta focus defensively.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket. I think it's important to get to the free throw line, Brad. It demonstrates that you're playing aggressively and that you're not settling for the jumper. Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Well, this man's in trouble. We're at the 2-minute mark. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Out on the right wing, number 42 with the foul. First personal foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
Chance to get an easy one here. Makes the foul shot. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
Second one, no good. Robertson receives the pass. Into their zone motion now. They work it around the perimeter. For two, goes. Long down court pass. Gets the J to fall. They'll work it around the arc. Goes up for two. Nails the jumper. 1 minute left to go. Looking for a good shot. He tries to knock down the three. Knocks it down. How about that play? They went through the high post again.
Certain offenses require that the ball goes through the high post. This will usually open up things on the wings and a low block, Brad. They did a great job of using the high post on that play.
Jones steps to the line for the first time. He hits it. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Second shot is no good. Number 23 takes the pass. Loose ball save. And we'll head back down to the other end. Opportunity now for an easy one. Hits that one. No problem so far at the free throw line tonight, Dick.
Well, they're making the most of the free ones.
He misses the second shot. And now getting set up here in a four and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
The Mocs go into their zone motion now. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc looking for the open jumper. There's a slam. Wow, what a finish on that back cut.
Great delivery on that back cut. He just hit him at the right time.
Works the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Dick, we had a couple of great performances out there today, and here are our players of the game.
These kids were awesome out there, both working hard and looking to help their teams any way they could, Brad. And that's what you like to see from players like this at this level.